Hello students, hope you all are doing well. Kindly watch these videos properly as some of the assignment questions are given from these videos only. Today we are going to start our module 3 of chapter 6, the three orders, and today our focus would be on the second order, that is the nobility. The noble possessed a central role in the feudal society. They had control over lands, which was the result of old custom known as the vassalage. So basically, vassal was a person who is subordinate to another. As we have studied earlier, that the feudal society was a society of hierarchy in which at different levels the one level was subordinate to another. So the subordinate one was known as the vassal. So the vassals, they received the protection and land from a lord in return for allegiance and performing military services for them and many others' duty as well. That's why a noble was a vassal of a king. What you all need to remember is that all the relations and all the subordination, the vassalage, everything was related to the land. The certain amount of land was given to the vassal, in lieu of which he has to perform the certain duty for his lord. So therefore, the base of the feudal society was a distribution of land. Thus, a noble accepted the king as his seigneur or lord in all the matters, and king had to give a mutual assurance that he would protect the vassals. As we all know that the period that we are talking about, that is the medieval period, there was a chaos and war and conflicts everywhere. So everywhere there was a feeling of terror and everyone wanted themselves to be protected. Thus emerged the feudal system and the vassalage. Under the link, that is under the vassalage, the seigneur, that is the lord, and the noble had to make vows with the Bible in the church. The vassal received a written charter or a staff or even a clod of earth as a symbol of land granted by his lord. The noble enjoyed several privileges. They had judicial powers and even right to issue coins. They also had power to raise their army, known as the feudal levies. A noble was lord of each and every person settled on his land. He possessed huge tracts of land, which included his residence, his personal fields, pastures, and the fields of the peasants and tenants who used to live on that land. The house of a noble was known as manor. The peasants cultivated their fields, also worked as cultivators on their fields, and as foot soldiers in the time of military needs they used to serve them as well. So whenever a land was given to a vassal or a noble by the king, all the people who used to live on that land, they were automatically subordinate to that noble. Now, a manorial estate played a very important role in this whole feudal system. Manorial estate was a place where a lord used to live. A lord house was known as manor house in feudal society. He could control peasants' villages in manorial estates, either in small number containing few dozens of houses or in large number consisting of around 50 to 60 houses of the peasants. That means a manor, it could be small as well as a big one. The manor estates were self-sufficient economic center where each and every requirement of daily life was fulfilled in an estate. The grains were grown in the fields, blacksmiths and carpenters maintained the lord equipments and refurnished the ornaments, whereas stonemasons managed their building. The women prepared fabrics and children worked in lord's gardens. The estate consisted of woodlands and forests where the lord did the hunting. The estate also contained pastures, as you can see in the picture given. The church was part of estate and the castle was there for defense, where knights lived. In England, the castles were developed as centers of administration and military strength under the feudal system. So we can see that how a manor was not just a land, but actually a very big land which contained everything that a lord might need. So basically you can compare it with a very large village in which all the facilities are available and it was self-sufficient. During this time, that is the medieval time, and during the feudal society, we also see an emergence of a different group which were known as knights. As we all have discussed, there were regular localized wars in Europe in medieval times. The insufficient peasants who were forced to become soldiers, and due to lack of good cavalry, it created various sort of problems for the nobles and kings to defend themselves. This led to the evolution of new section of people in society known as knight. They were under the lord who was subordinate of the king. The knights paid his lord customary fees and pledged to fight for him in the war. The lords granted a piece of land called fief for knights in lieu of their services as the as their protectorate. So basically the same is happening with the knights as well. Like the nobles who used to get the land from the kings, the knights used to get the land from the nobles, and the land was known as fief. The fief of a knight could be hereditary and was of any size from 1000 to 2000 acres or even could be more. A knight's fief consisted of a house for him and his family, church settlements of dependent together with water mills and various sorts of gardens. The peasant cultivated the land of the fief. In exchange, the knight paid his lord a regular fees and promised to fight for him in war. A knight could serve more than one lord but remained loyal to his own lord. So basically we can now you can clearly understand that how a land which basically used to belong to the king, and as he was unable to protect it, the land used to pass on to the different classes. Initially the king used to pass it to the nobles and they have a bond of vassal, and then the nobles used to pass it to the knights, they have a bond of vassalage, and similarly the knights used to pass them to the peasants and they have a bond of vassalage. Every time when it used to pass from one class to another, the size of the land used to decrease. So this is the base structure of the feudal society, the distribution and division of land in lieu of the services needed. Therefore, in our next module, we are basically going to focus on our third order, that is the peasantry. The peasantry further consisted of two categories, the serfs and the freemen. And the difference between them, we will basically focus on that in our next module.